Hey, thanks for joining me, Jason DeVilliers, courtside. We have Russia versus Finland. We got Finland on the side nearest me, you have Russia on the side away. Once again, thank you for joining me. Thank you for having me in your living room, Jason DeVilliers. We're in the first set, 1 point from the technical timeout. Finland looking for the side out, looking to get there first, 2-11, and they do. And that's the technical timeout, Finland. Finland nursing a 1 point lead this first set. We have Taru Lahti and Anina Parkkinen against Get Ready's Svetlana Kolomina and Nadezhda Makroguzova. I'm going to say that again, Makroguzova. Charlie, who you bothering over there, man? Here's the serve, 1 point lead. We're back in action, Russia, Finland. Cross court. Svetlana Kolomina with the side out. Kolomina, 20 years of age. Up and down set, trying to go cross court. Cross court on that shot. Number one, Taru Lahti. Taru Lahti, 26 years of age. They go to Nadezhda, and there's the bop off the block. Pretty good touch, but out of bounds, and now the Russians trail within one. Nadezhda. It's a tongue twister, guys. Makroguzova. Once again, 21 years of age. Possibly out of city of Albanese, Russia. Gets the trickler and the ball drops, and now we are at 12 up. Wow, there's a left side serve. Follows her, tethers along, creates the string, and that ball's near the top of the tape, and now the Russians have the lead after the technical timeout. 3-1 after the technical timeout, and intelligently and quickly, the timeout is called by the Finns. Timing is called. There's the blocking signal telling her to serve. They do have a serving preference. They're going to go back to Lahti. Left side serve. Handled very nicely. Perfect pass. Up and down set. A little bit of a drifter. That's handled. And finishing pursuit because it crosses the pole is Nadezhda. Now the Finns get the side out and trail by one. 13 to 14. Pretty pretty decent pass. Colomina, right down the middle. When in doubt, sometimes you got a pull, and sometimes sometimes you have a pull switch, sometimes you have just a back row switch, and metal's always going to be your best bet. Maybe with a little bit more speed next time. Svetlana, Palomino to serves. Svetlana, 20 years of age. There's a nice outside set. There's the up and down, and unable to land and turn around is Nadezhda, and the Finns are back in business, but trailing by one. Taru Lahti, number one from Finland. And there's an ace. Ties the setup at 15 apiece. Pass out of the middle set. That ball dug, looking for 16. There's the cut. Wow, what a great reach, and unable to recover all the Russians. And now Finland leads 16-15, and just as quick as the first timeout was called, we have another timeout. Called by the Russians. Actually, let's take that back. Taru Lahti is actually number two. And number one is Anina. Anina parking in the serve, hits the tape, and there is another ace. Doesn't look like she's serving a player in particular. It just looks like she's serving very competitively out of the middle. Let's see if I can do that. Played off the net and hit cross court, and finally Russia stops the bleeding and ties the game at 16 apiece. Should be 17-18? Should be 7-8, right?
What am I missing? No!
It's a switch if it's 18, guys.
Switch! Support the bike, top. So. 16-15, timeout and one ace. You can't miss this one.
16-15.
It was 16-15, they took a timeout.
And then an ace.
Ace, 17-15.
Side out, yeah. Yep, they're switching.
Yeah.
They got it right. Let's give it. Give that man a round of applause. A Okay, now we fix the score. It's gonna be 17-18. There's the switch. The Russians with the serve. That's Palomino and the cut. It's dug. Great play, looking for 18. A little too much into the well on that one. And now the score is 19-17 in favor of the Finns. Pretty good match. Everybody coming out strong. Wow, there's a good look away cut, and the score is now 18-19. Bit of a bumper to the net, and now we have a situation exactly where you want to be for this capacity crowd is watching at 19-19. Nadezhda, serve, cross court, got in, and the Finns back in the driver's seat, set point opportunity number one. Mario, the head official, always on top of things. Very good staff the entire day, to be totally honest. This is set point opportunity number one, and there's the trickle down the line. Doug, the Finns, looking for the match. The set denied by Makroguzova. Nadezhda gets the block, and now the score is 20-20. Billy, what's up, baby? Score is now 21-20 by the Finns. Set point opportunity number two. That ball served to the net. There's your switch. 21-21. Juanita Parkkinen with the service error. The team's relatively young. The oldest player on this team is 26 years old. That's Tyro Lati from Finland. And from there you got 22, 21, and 20. Patrick Kuzova serves. Parkkinen, cross court, got it. Set point opportunity number three for the Finns. This time Taro Lahti serves. Taro Lahti, 26 years of age. Looking for the jump floater, possibly out of the middle. We've got our bunch of points. Wow, handled very nicely by Kolomina. Kolomina reads the hot switch, goes cut over. And now the score is 22-22. Outside set by the Finns, and wow, what a nasty drop. For an up and down cut, that thing had some movement on it. Set point opportunity number four. Counting in my head. Yep. Set point opportunity number four. There's a drifter. Left shoulder serve. That's tight and trouble all over it. And the Finns finally, after their fourth attempt, finish this first set and win 24-22. Take a break in the air and set up my line. Thank you. live. This is the second set, Finland versus Russia. Finland won the first set and drawing first blood on that again is the Finns. Once again, the beginning of the second set. Thank you for having me in your living room. I am Jason DeVilliers. And this is Platform 1440. Pretty decent block. Jumping off to a quick lead are the Finns. Terry Holland, thanks for joining me. Tell your friends, tell your mother, tell your father, send a telegram, send a candygram. Tell them I am coming out of, supposed to be NY Varsity Sports, but instead I wound up on my page for some reason. I gotta figure out how to bring that back. I gotta get out of here. You guys gotta find this song in my varsity. Welcome. This is Platform 1440. We're on court 5. We are live. There's a block and not be able to be covered. Finland playing really, really good volleyball right now. There's a switch in this second set. Finland nursing a 4-3 lead. Once again, we're in the second set. Second set, Finland won the first set 24-22. And I guess, I don't know if that's an unexpected or expected surprise, but there it is just the same. Finland, winners of the first set, find themselves up 5-3. Going off the switch, and there's your line off the touch. And now it's 6-3. Russians better talk it over and they do. All right, once again, thanks for joining me. I'm going to bring you guys up to speed. Finland won the first set, pretty much 18-18, 19-19, all the way across the board, with Finland winning 24-22. I thought Harkonnen served really well, and I thought Taro Lahti played some pretty good defense and hit well. And that's the story of the match on that one. Adrian, once again, thanks for joining me. Tell your friends, share this post. They can all come in, tell them the air is fine. So, for Finland, you have number 2, Taro Lahti, and number 1, Nina Parkkinen. And for the Russians, you have number 1, Nadezhda Makro-Nakoguzova, and Svetlana Kolomina. I gotta get this name, Makro-Guzova, about 20 and 21 years of age, out of Sibiu-Obinsk, Russia. We're back on the court, the score is 6-3. This side of the net, in the light blue, those are the Finns. Beautiful shot on two, finally gets this, a much needed side out. So receiving on the left side is Anina Parkkinen, and on the right side is Tari Lahti. Parkkinen, 22 years of age, Lahti is 26. Does a touch on the block, she knows she's got to go, and went for the more difficult shot, and that drills, drips into the tape. The does not make it over, and the score is now 7-4. We're in beautiful, sunny, and kinda hot Las Vegas, Nevada. Looking for someone to spend the weekend, you should come through, especially my people from California. It's a 4-hour drive, just don't get a speeding ticket. I got stopped by the police coming in. Really a nice guy though. Modesta has a pretty good standing jump, but goes out of the middle. J-hook pass. Head balls dug. Looking for a scoring opportunity. Looking to get back in. Drifts to her right. Cross body to the left. And now the Russians close the lead within one. The score is 6-7. The cut. Didn't know if she went, had to take it or not, and in that moment of hesitancy was not able to execute, and there we go. There's a switch. 8-6 in favor of Finland. Finland playing tremendously good volleyball in this playoff atmosphere. Down set, transition, line over. And a whole lot of that. Looking for the back set. Things trying to side out and cross court hits the top of the tape. Creates a more enhanced version of the cut shot, if you will, and there it is. Serve out of the middle. Left shoulder serve. Worked out pretty well. Lost our court vision, but set right at back end. The Russian sat out very well. Svetlana Kolomina played an excellent tournament as well. Is that 2-9 or 1-0? Is that 2-9 or 1-0? Timeout. I can't see the scoreboard from there. This is my line judge. Scores 12-9, the Finns. Got a little bit of their momentum back, and it's like they're going to be well on their way to winning the second set of all things stay the same. Which is what I hope the Russians are talking about. Optimistic, if not hopeful, that adjustments are in order. Wow, interception on that good disguise on the cross shot. Much needed side out for the Russians, and I'm gonna keep saying his name until I get it right. Mako Gozova. To serve. A standing floater this time. Pretty decent, but an even better pass by defense. Line over, there's a dig. Kalamina going. Wow! Trying to get a little cute on that third hit. It was Lati, and now the Russians got a real point off of that. And the score is 11-12. There's a shot that's over the top and just out of bounds, and just like that, the team who was enjoying a 3-point lead has found themselves in a tie. 3 unanswered points for the Russians. I think she's probably gonna go left shoulder again. She has to be really, really careful though. She got wind blowing right to left on your TV screen, and she went a little bit safer with that, and sometimes you have to pick the gray area between safe and competitive. I mean, come on, look, no one wants to be safe, you know? At this level, if you serve lollipops, you get whipped. I get that. So, I guess what I have to say about that is, what do you call it when your coach wants you to serve competitively and not serve out? That's called pressure. Finally, timeout is called then. Timeout's called by the Finns, actually. Didn't know if they gave Russia the point on that. I'm pretty sure she got the touch block. I'm gonna find out when they get back. Show the serve again. Handled okay. Outside set, and they didn't give it to him. There's the block. There's the cover, and there's the block and the cover again. Set out of the middle, and wow, the I formation lined up for that. There's the dig. Trying to trans out. There's a block that's not covered. Finn gets 2 covers. Russia gets none. Very, very important. Should be a switch. Should be 14 up, but 13-13, just the same. Lati tries to go too deep into the well, but boy, did Russia have a beat on that. Blocker jumping into it, and the digger digging into the cut. Svetlana Kolomina, once again, as I said, has played a magnificent tournament on defense and tough competitive serving. Jump floater, left shoulder. Wow, good. Good serve. And that ball hits the outside part of the line and gets the bounce, and your switch is 14 up. Parkin in the serve. Parkin in with a jump floater. Svetlana over the top and in, and scoring the first point off the switch are the Russians. Medezda. There it goes. Gotta keep saying it. Mako Gozova. First time I've ever heard that name today. First time in my entire life, and it's not gonna be the last, because this woman is just throwing it down. 16-14. Russia gets a 2-point lead. The block cover, nice and patient. Parkin goes for the cut. And then that line has got to be kicking herself over that. She's like, man, my partner's giving me all everything I need. I just got to come up with that dick. This time, serve right shoulder out of the middle. Podesta gets dug. Ooh, that looked like it could have went out, but who wants to take the chance? And who needs to take the chance when you could do the same move all over again, but this time with success, 2-point leaders. 17-15, Russia with the lead. They go to Parkkinen, perfect pass, hand set. Drifting to the outside and line for line. Go the Russians and the Finns, with Parkkinen going line over now to score 16-17. I wonder if you dare drop a short ball on this team. There's a drifter, there's a touch on the block, she knows she's got to go, and right there is the scene of the crime is Nadezhda. And cross-court takes a little bit something off of it, throws off the timing of the block. Just in front of the dig, and the score is 18-16 for the Russians. And there's a crowd behind me. Actually, the huge crowd. That ball hits the top of the tape, does not go over, and here's your switch. Once again, this is the second set. For those of you that joined me a little bit late, and for those of you that joined me live a few minutes ago, or should I say, joined me live at the beginning of the second set, the Russians are up 1 this set, but down 0-1 in the match. Left shoulder serve, pendulum nicely, and dribbling straight into the defense. She just shook her head on that. And man, trying to make up for the touch. What's up, man? Trying to make up for the touch. It's 18 up, I think.
Oh, is it really?
Yeah, man.
Oh, we got a game.
Yeah, first set was Finns, 24-22.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, we got Russia. Makrovidova.
So you got Cuba behind you.
That ball's out of bounds, and a sigh of relief by Blatzy on a fist pump by Parkkinen. And now the Finns lead 19-18. Jump floater. It's time they go short. Podesta. Wow. Man, did she just reach high and let gravity take care of the rest. Any place in the world you'd rather be, right here, court 5, 19 up, the Russians staring 0-1 in the face, trying to get a play, and the Finns, no sweat on their palms, match point opportunity number 1. Parkkinen's played a magnificent match. They've all played great. I mean, they're here, it's playoffs. Got a jump floater coming. Will she go down the middle? I'd like to see that. There's a left shoulder that goes back. Losing her court vision, but getting it back, going line, almost showing the defense where she was gonna go, and she's like, man, I wish I could have that one back. Wow, there's the left shoulder serve, and that finally came back to bite her, and now the Russians are up set point. Number 1, 21-20. They serve left shoulder a whole bunch of times, and I like it. If I'm the coach, I'm loving it, because it's not about fast results as it is about constant pressure, constantly jabbing an area where you think she's weak, constantly jabbing an area where you know she's protecting, she's stepping in, unless she has to face her platform, possibly J-hook a couple. And at the end of this, at the near end of the set, it's paid dividends. It's gotten some out-of-system plays, and at this level, sometimes that's all you can ask. The Finns trying to end this right here. Wow, deep position 1, handled okay. Creating her string out of the middle. Drifting out, bringing it back to the middle. It's Kalamina. Svetlana. ice cold on that swing. Set point opportunity number two for the Russians. Wow, there's a swing cross court. Parkkinen picking up where she left off. It's one of those games where like the middle of the sand is gonna start to sink in because of all the activity from digging in string creations out of the middle. Maybe it's one of those things you just want to set the pins, right? Sooner or later it's gonna become the high part of it, right? Call me lazy, but wow, there it is. There's a line over and now, match point opportunity for the Finns. Match point opportunity number two. Yeah, but like I said, call me lazy, but I like my set near the lowest part of the net where I have the best range with the best result possible, and there's an ace! Boy, she played the outs, so she could finally thump one down the middle. Tried her fortune there, and fortune has smiled on the Finns this match. Winners, 2-0. Identical 24-22. 24-22. For all of you at home, thank you for joining me. Stick around, I'll be back in a bit. But for now, I say see you soon.